Title transition is a trendy motion graphics that can be used to highlight any topic in your videos. So in today's video, we're going to create a nice and simple title transition inside of DaVinci Resolve in a few simple steps. And you still have a chance to participate in the giveaway and win your favorite pack from easyedit.pro. Follow the link given in the description. Hey guys, this is Vikas from Skyline Motions, and without any further ado, let's get started. Alright, so before we get started, we have to do some basic setting as usual. So click on the setting button in the corner and set the size of this project 1920 by 1080. Select a frame rate. So in this case, I'm using 30 frames per second. Click on save. Now let's create this animation inside of this fusion page. So we have to take a new fusion composition first. So just go to this media pool, right click on that, click on new fusion composition. Let's call it fusion. Duration, make it 5 seconds long, which is good enough for one transition. Frame rate 30 and click on create. Now let's drag and drop this fusion composition on the timeline just like that, and then go to the fusion page. And here we have this media out node, so just drag this media out to the side for now. And for this animation, we need any image or video file, so just go to this media pool, right click on that, click on import media and select any image or video file. So in this case, I'm using this image that I have downloaded from pixels.com. Select the image or video file and click on open. Now drag and drop this image on this flow window. Hit F2 on the keyboard to rename, or you can also right click on this node and click on rename and call it image. Hit enter. Now drag and drop this image on this viewer. You can close this media pool. You can click on this single viewer. Now we have to fit this image according to the project size, so it's very simple. Select the image, add a transform node, and this transform is going to be the controller of this image. So hit F2 on the keyboard, call it controller. Now we have to take a new background. So this is the background button. Let's drag and drop on this flow window. Hit F2 on the keyboard, call it matte, because I'm gonna use this background as a matte. Now we have to merge this controller with this matte. So it's very simple. Let's drag and drop the merge node on this flow window. Inside of this merge node, we have 4 different points. So the yellow point is for background, green is for foreground, and this is the output, and this is the effect mask. So I'm going to use this matte as a background. So connect the yellow background point with this matte and green foreground point with this controller and drag this merge one to the viewer. Now click on the fit button and we have to adjust the image. So select the controller and set it like this. Now we have to make this image black and white, so it's very simple again. Select the merge one, add a color corrector node with this, drag this color corrector to the viewer, select the color corrector, go to the inspector window, and here we have the saturation. Let's set the saturation value 0 and make it black and white. You can adjust this value according to you. So I'm gonna use this gain parameter. Let's increase the gain amount. Set the value maybe 1.2. Perfect. Now we have to animate this image. Select the color corrector node, add a transform node, and this transform is going to be the animation. So select the transform, hit F2 on the keyboard, call it animation. Go to the inspector window and here we have the size. So just go to the end of this animation, right click on size, click on animate. Go to very first frame of this animation. Let's increase the size a little bit. So I'm going to set the value maybe 1.2. Perfect. And now we have a zoom out animation. Perfect. After that, we have to place this image inside of a text. So it's very simple again. Let's take a new text node. Select the text and type a single letter that you like. So I'm going to type R. Let's select a extra bold font style. So in this case, I'm using the Gotham black font style. Now drag and drop to the viewer. Select the text. Let's increase the size a little bit. So I'm going to set the size value maybe 1.6, which is looking perfect. Now let's drag and drop over here. Maybe you have to fit the character inside of this frame just like that. Perfect. After that, we have to animate the text. So select the text, add a transform node, and by using this transform, we have to animate the text. So just go to one frame number 30, which is equal to 1 second according to 30 frame per second. Select the transform. Here we have the center, so right click on center, click on animate, and go to on frame number 120, which is equal to 4 seconds according to 30 frames per second. Right click on center, click on set key and lock the position as it is. Go to the end of this animation and let's drag the text outside of this frame. You can drag and drop the transform to the viewer and simply drag the text outside of this frame. Perfect. And go to very first frame of this animation, and this time we have to drag it down. Perfect. And now we have a nice and simple animation, but this animation is linear right now, so we have to make it smoother. Just go to the spline window, hit F4 on the keyboard to full screen, check this transform one, click on fade button. We have four different keyframes, so select these two keyframes, hit H to smooth, or you can also click on this smooth button, hold this handle and create a nice smooth curve, and do the same thing for this one. Perfect. And now you can close this spline window, and here we have nice and simple animation. And I'm gonna use this text as a mat, so we have to take a new merge node. And again, I'm gonna use this text as a mat, so we have to connect this yellow background point with this transform and green foreground point with this animation, and drag this merge to the viewer. Now our foreground is over on the background, but we have to place the foreground inside of this background, so it's very simple. Select the merge tool, go to this inspector window, and here we have the operator. Let's place the foreground inside of this background, so we have to change the operator over to in, and now we will get something like this. And after that we have to merge this with a background, so let's take a new background node, select the background and select a white color, hit OK, and let's merge this background with this output. So I'm gonna use this output as a foreground and this one as a background, so it's very simple. You can connect the foreground output with the background output, and we will get the new merge. Let's drag the merge to the viewer, and we will get something like this. After that we have to create a stroke effect, so select the text and the transform node, right click on that, click on copy, and here we have to paste the copy, so click on paste, or you can also hit Ctrl V to paste. And after that let's drag the transform to the viewer, select the text, and we have to make it a stroke, so just go to the setting, and here we have the text outline option in the appearance, so click on the text outline button and let's set the thickness. So I'm going to set the value 0.003 and make it like this. Perfect. Now we have to merge this stroke with the main output, so we have to use this stroke as a foreground, so we have to connect the output of this transform with the main output. This is the very easiest way to connect these layers. Drag the merge 4 to the viewer. Now select the text and let's drag it like this. Now we have to blend the stroke with the background, so select the merge 4, and here we have the apply mode, which is the blending mode. Let's change this to overlay, and finally we will get something like this. Now we have to create the rectangle, so let's take a new background. This background is going to be the rectangle, so let's call it rectangle. Attach a rectangle mask with this. Drag the rectangle to the viewer, select the rectangle, and let's create a perfect rectangle. So set the value maybe 0.28 and set the width value maybe 0.6. Perfect. And now we have to merge this rectangle with the background. So let's take a new merge node, connect this yellow background point with this merge 4 and green foreground point with this rectangle. Drag this merge 5 to the viewer, select the rectangle, which is the background node. And here we have the opacity, which is called alpha. So let's set the alpha value 0.9 and make it a little transparent. Select the rectangle and drag it over here. You can place the rectangle anywhere in the frame. Now we have to animate the rectangle. So select the rectangle, go to on frame number 60, which is equal to 2 seconds according to 30 frames per second. Here we have the width, right click on width, click on animate. Go to on frame number 15, which is equal to half a second according to 30 frames per second. Set the width value 0. And now we will get something like this. Now we have to make it smoother, so it's very simple again. Go to spline window, hit F4 on the keyboard to full screen. You can minimize all the nodes. This time we need only the rectangle, so uncheck the transforms and click on fade button. Select both the keyframes of this rectangle, hit H to smooth. Hold this handle and create a nice smooth curve. Close this spline window. And after that we have to create a main text. So Take a new text node, attach the text node with the main output. So it's very simple again. Connect the output of this text with the background and we will get the new merge. Let's drag and drop to the viewer. Select the text and type anything, whatever you want. And select your favorite font style. So in this case, I'm using the Arkitech bold font style. You can use any different font style that you like. Set the text in the center. You can increase the size a little bit. I'm going to set the value 0.09. Place the text in the center of this rectangular box. After that, we have to animate the tracking. So it's very simple again. Just go to on frame number 60, which is equal to 2 seconds. Right click on tracking, click on animate. Go to on frame number 15, which is equal to half a second. Set the tracking value 0 and make it like this. And now let's animate the opacity as well. So select the text, go to the setting, and here we have the opacity. So just go to on frame number 60, right click on opacity, click on animate, go to on frame number 15, set the opacity value 0. And now we will get something like this. But we have to do one more thing. We have to create a smooth animation. So just go to the spline window, hit F4 on the keyboard to full screen. This time we don't need the rectangle, so uncheck the rectangle. And here we have two different parameters inside of the text. So let's do one by one. Let's uncheck the opacity. Check the corrector spacing first. Click on fade button. Highlight both the keyframes. Hit H to smooth. Or you can also click on this smooth button. Hold this handle and create a nice smooth curve. Just like that. And you can uncheck the corrector spacing. Check the opacity. Click on fade. Select both the keyframe. And you can simply hit S on the keyboard to smooth. And then close this spline window, and finally we will get this type of animation, which is looking perfect. Now let's create the final transition. So we have to take a new background node, select the background and attach a polygon node with this. So hold control and scroll down to zoom out, and this is the polygon. Let's attach the polygon with this background. You can remove the animation from the polyline stroke. Right click on this text and click on remove polygon 1 polyline. Now just go to on frame number 30, which is equal to 1 second, and let's create a polygon shape just like that. And then right click on this text, click on animate, go to on frame number 120 as well. Right click on the text, click on set key, go to the end of this animation, highlight these control points and drag it on the right hand side by holding shift and right arrow key. And then go to very first frame of this animation, highlight these two control points, hold shift on the keyboard and press left arrow key and set it like this. Perfect. And now we will get something like this. You can drag and drop the background to the viewer. Now let's make it smoother. Just go to the spline window, hit F4 on the keyboard. This time uncheck the text, check the polyline only, click on fit button, highlight these two keyframes, hit S to smooth and create a nice smooth curve just like that. And do the same thing for this one. Perfect. And then you can close this spline window. And I'm gonna use this animated background as a mat. So we have to take a new merge node. Let's connect the yellow background point with this mat, which is the background, and green foreground point with this main output. And this is the merge 7. Let's drag and drop to the viewer. After that, let's place the foreground inside of the background. So it's very simple. Select the merge 7, go to the inspector window, and here we have the operator. Let's change this over to in. And now we will get something like this. Perfect. You can click on the fit button. Let's connect the media out with the main output just like that, and then go to the edit page, and here our animation is ready for render. So click on the loop button, go to full screen by hitting Control F, and let's have a look. Alright, so that is it for now. I hope you like this video. If you have any question, drop a message on my Instagram or comment down below. And if you are watching this video first time on the channel, please hit the subscribe button, turn on the bell notification for more interesting videos, and also hit the like button for this video. My name is Vikash, and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye bye.